additional ground available to wife are number one, bigamy during the lifetime of one spouse, the other spouse means the husband has remarried another woman. And if you make it a vice versa situation where the wife has remarried, it is not a ground for divorce for the husband. It is what law says. It is certainly a gender bias. Life is reflected. What can be the reason behind it? All of you are free to think over it, and if find any cogent reason, then we discuss. Another additional ground for the wife is where a husband has been guilty of rape, sodomy or bestiality. Such offense may be in respect of the wife herself or maybe in respect of others. But if a woman is found to have a sexual relationship out of this bad luck, it is not directly a ground for the divorce, though it may be covered under cruelty, mental cruelty it may be covered. But when it is a specific and direct ground for the divorce for female woman, wife, why not to the husband? Why husband and wife are not being dealt with equally? This again I would like to say certainly reflects a biased, gender biasness. There may be some reason behind it, but I am unable to think what may be the reason. Another additional ground for the wife for decree of divorce, that husband has failed to pay maintenance granted by court under section 18 of the Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act, section 125 CRPC. So non-payment of the maintenance has been made a ground for divorce for wife. If some maintenance has to be given by the wife to the husband, and if she is not paying, then it is not a ground for the divorce. So these three grounds are the additional grounds available to the wife only, to her. Another ground for the divorce is the repudiation of the marriage. When marriage was solemnized, before she was 15 years of age, and she repudiated the marriage after attaining the 18 years, but before the age of 18 years. पंद्रह से अठारह साल से पहले उसकी शादी हो गई लड़की की, अब जो अपने चिल्ड्रन मैरिज की बात करी थी वो कैसी मैरिज थी, वॉइडेबल मैरिज थी, और वॉइडेबल मैरिज को चैलेंज किया जा सकता था, वॉइड डिक्लेयर कराया जा सकता था. सो लॉ हैज गिवन एन ऑप्शन टू द सच चिल्ड्रेन वेदर टू कंटिन्यू विद दैट मैरिज और टू ऑप्ट फॉर रेपुडिएशन ऑफ द मैरिज. So if wife has not repudiated the marriage, it could be a ground for divorce also. Means even when the time given by the law to repudiate the marriage has past, it is still a ground for divorce, still a ground for the divorce. But why to only females, not to males also? So you must write it down, the grounds in brief. Simple question should be written by you. What are the grounds available to a husband for divorce, and what are the grounds available to a woman, wife, for divorce? Here we are talking of grounds, but if we talk of the modes, then the position would be different. Then 13b will also come into picture. And if we talk of the different modes of the modes to come out of a bad log, as we discussed this question yesterday, then section 11 and 12 also come into picture. Declaration of marriage as void or voidable as void. So there are certain case law on this divorce. You must write down a answer also, what is the distinction between judicial separation and divorce. Now we will come to section 13A. 13A provides a discretion to the court, alternative relief in divorce proceeding. When a decree of judicial separation कैन बी पास, आप नोट कर लीजिए, क्वेश्चन अटेम्प्ट करना है आपको. व्हेन ए डिक्री ऑफ जुडिशियल सेपरेशन कैन बी पास बाय ए कोर्ट इंस्टेड ऑफ ए डिक्री फॉर डिवोर्स. सेक्शन 13A वुड बी द आंसर. I have just hinted you and you try to attempt it. I am not discussing it, what are those grounds. You yourself read and find it out. There are so many cases, leading cases on this adultery and क्रूअलिटी, अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट केस ऑफ द दस्ताने वर्सेस दस्ताने 1976 सुप्रीम कोर्ट, मीनिंग ऑफ द क्रूअलिटी, फिजिकल मेंटल कंडोनेशन ऑफ क्रूअलिटी, अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट केस. And on mental cruelty, leading case is the Bhagat versus D. Bhagat, V. Bhagat versus D. Bhagat, AIR 1994, Supreme Court. There are certain other case laws also. And one more important aspect of this divorce is the irretrievable breakdown of the marriage. जहाँ लंबे समय तक झगड़े हो गए हैं, बहुत गंभीर झगड़े हो गए हैं, deep differences have surfaced, and there is no remote possibility of restoring back to the relationship. So in such case the marriage is said to be irretrievably breakdown. So irretrievable breakdown of the marriage. Samar Ghosh versus Jaya Ghosh 2007, bracket mein 3 SCJ 253. इस केस लॉ को आपको जरूर पढ़ना चाहिए, एक दस्ताने वाला केस आपको जरूर पढ़ना चाहिए, और एक भगत बी भगत वर्सेस डी भगत, यू कैन नोट इट डाउन. आई विल सेंड यू द जिस्ट ऑफ दिस केस लॉ. एंड अनदर केस ऑफ इररिट्रायवेबल ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ मैरिज इज नवीन कोहली वर्सेस नीलू कोहली 2006 सुप्रीम कोर्ट. द ऑनरेबल सुप्रीम कोर्ट कैप्ड दिस irretrievable breakdown of marriage as the cruelty to the other party. In 2009, Supreme Court again come across a question whether the mens rea is necessary as an element in cruelty. And Supreme Court decided the legal cruelty and the mental cruelty. It is of very academic question, of very academic importance. What is the cruelty, physical or mental, and whether all type of these cruelties will fall down under the definition of a legal cruelty. It would be the same as we studied the law of insanity, Macnaughton rule. Legal insanity is different from the mental insanity. So in the same manner, what is the legal cruelty? Suman Kapoor versus Sudhir Kapoor 2009 Supreme Court. One must know what was held, what was this case, what was held. On ground of desertion, there is another case, Savitri Pandey versus Premchandra Pandey, AIR 2002 Supreme Court. Court discussed the factum of separation, animus desertandi, intention to desert without any reasonable cause. All these points of desertion were discussed in this case law. We also discussed the effect of, you can make a question on this point. What is the effect of accusing by the respondent or condoning by the respondent the conduct of the by the petitioner, conduct of the respondent. If petitioner accuse or condones the conduct of the respondent, what will be the effect? On this point, there is a very important case law, Savitri Pandey versus Prem Chandra Pandey. AIR 2002, Supreme Court 591. It is on the ground of the desertion. This case law is on ground of desertion. Not on desertion, it is on the ground of the effect, legal effect of condonation. Honorable Supreme Court held, in the absence of cohabitation and the conjunction of marriage, the appellant was disentitled to claim divorce on ground of desertion. Desertion was an issue because the question involved was whether their cohabitation or conjunction, if started, then whether such party would still have a right to claim a divorce on ground of this desertion. On insanity, Ram Narayan versus Rameshwar, AIR 1989, Supreme Court 149. So at least these 3-4 grounds, cruelty, desertion, mental cruelty, you must know the legal leading cases. These are not more than 5 or 6 cases. So you must be very well prepared on these case law. These case law may base the any question in the written examination or may be asked in the interviews also. And nowadays what is happening, the marriages are irretrievably breaking down. So irretrievable breakdown आप द मैरिजेस पे जो केस लॉ हैं, जो मैंने एक आपको नोट कराया, 2 और केस लॉ हैं, अनिल कुमार जैन वर्सेस माया जैन 2009 SCC, मनीष गोयल वर्सेस रोहिणी गोयल AIR 2010 SC, ये बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है। और इररिट्रीवेबल ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ द मैरिज के बहुत सारे केस लॉ सामने आने पे डिफरेंट कोर्ट्स ने ये ऑब्जर्व किया कि सच केस ग्रीवेंसेस ऑफ सच पार्टीज मस्ट बी एड्रेस्ड एंड लिबरलाइजेशन यू कैन से द प्रोसीजर फॉर गेटिंग डाइवोर्स मस्ट बी लिबरलाइज्ड because there is no purpose. So Law Commission of India in its 71st report has made some recommendations on irretrievable breakdown of the theory. When the matrimonial relation has for that period ceased to exist de facto, it should, unless there are special reasons to contrary, cease to exist de jure also. In general, it is not in the interest of the parties or in the interest of the public that a man and a woman should remain bound together as husband and wife in law when for a lengthy period they have ceased to be such. In fact, in the case of such separation of essential purposes of marriage have been frustrated, and its further continuance is in general not merely unless but mischievous. There is no purpose of keeping such a dead relationship alive, no purpose is going to be achieved. So you must know the latest development of law, this irretrievable breakdown of the marriages, which has become a common feature nowadays, and the Marriage Laws Amendment Bill 2001, insertion of Section 13C, 13D. A Marriage Laws Amendment Bill in 2010 has been introduced in Parliament, but it has not passed, and as a result, these recommendations have not been incorporated in the Hindu Marriage Act. So you must also know this Marriage Laws Amendment Bill 2001 in light of the Law Commissions of India 71st report. One aspect we will discuss that would be relating to the duties of the courts while dealing with such a sensitive issue of husband and wife. So we will take it tomorrow.